We're talking to Coach Cliff right here at Outlaws. Coach Cliff, break down the Mahrez fight, the Santa Cruz fight, the DeMarco fight.
Well, the DeMarco fight didn't last long.
No.
DeMarco,
he looked great.
Just seemed like he had his, you know, it's so hard when it's a short fight to know what really is going to happen. But DeMarco didn't seem to be in command very early, seemed very confident on what he was going to do, and just too accurate, too tough, too skilled.
And then talking about Abner Mahrez, amazing fight. Maybe one of the best fights I've seen this year, and forth. And the other guy, Andres Gutierrez, big heart, no quit in him.
You know,
got stopped on a cut late.
One of the things about 126, and I'm not taking anything away from the guys, but, you know, we all have the same skin, muscle, and nerve cells, right? And so 126, they're even the most powerful don't have quite enough power to knock each other out in one shot. So they end up taking a tremendous amount of damage. And man, that was just an amazing fight. Abner was hitting him with everything but the kitchen sink.
I bet he cut him.
Yeah, and I took a huge improvement under Robert Garcia. Huge improvement in his skills, I thought, moving back left and right and punching and moving and then punching again.
And he fought a very durable, tough fighter in Andres Gutierrez.
And instead of just kind of just engaging him one-on-one and just proving he's tough, we knew Abner was tough, but now I think he's got that next layer of skills that's starting to make it look like, you know, that kind of more Hall of Fame level.
Mahrez. Okay, he won. Leo Santa Cruz won.
Now, I'm a big Leo Santa Cruz fan.
Who is it?
I'll say that from the beginning.
Okay, you love Leo.
He's a nice kid, and I love the hands-up style. You know, when somebody has a hands-up style and they don't throw a lot of punches, I tend not to like that too much. But here, he's got this hands-up style, elbows down, and throws just so many punches. And he doesn't just headhunt. He throws to the body, throws back to the head. And he's just not afraid of anybody. Careless. Smiling the whole time. Having a great time.
The fight could have stopped in the fifth round because Mahrez was doing so good in the fifth. They let it continue 3-4 more rounds. Santa Cruz.
Yeah.
The ref looked to a lot of people in the arena that it was stopped early. What did you think?
No, I think, you know, look, everybody in the arena, they just want to see the fight. So, you know, you're always disappointed when it ends. But Thomas Taylor, I think he did a good job. He's like, look, you're just getting racked with combos. This is the kind of fight that, you know, you years later, I want to look you in the face and know that you're okay.
That you're not going to be like Muhammad
Ali.
I
didn't damage you, and you didn't become somebody like Meldrick Taylor, which you're never the same after the fight. Everybody thought he got stopped too early, and meanwhile, he was never the same after that Chavez fight.
All right, there you have it, Coach Cliff here at Outlaws. Who wins, Mahrez or Santa Cruz, if they have a fight, a rematch?
I think Santa Cruz, I think the length gets to Mahrez, just a little tall for him. You know, that's going to be a great fight. And if I think Santa Cruz is going to win, it's like a 55-45. You know, it's not a landslide, that's
all
for
right,
sure.
There you have it, Coach Cliff. FaceTheDrewPoint.com, Logistic Back Reporting.